High electricity has passed through the motherboard of the air conditioner, and its switching IC has burst. You can see it. I have changed the IC of this motherboard, but still, it has not been fixed. I didn't find any other damaged components in this motherboard. The switching IC number is TNY278PN. Let me show you what problem it is making. I will pass electricity through it. See carefully when I pass electricity through it. The motherboard's display turned on, and the fuse burst badly. Let me show you in slow motion. Now I will test this motherboard and try to fix it. I found no other damaged parts, but it has already been repaired. But it is not the issue because the repaired motherboard does work. First of all, let's understand how is its circuit working. This is its main power supply, means the line wire is given here, and the neutral is given here. The line wire is connected to this fuse. Let me show you the other side of the motherboard. This is the fuse. And this fuse is connected with this trace, which is a ZNR. This is a safety device. If voltages cross above 250 volts in the control board, this could short circuit and make the fuse burst. A capacitor is installed further. Then a line filter is installed. The electricity is also passing through this trace as well. What component is it? This is a triac IC installed for the fan blower motor. It is used to operate the blower motor. If it also gets short circuit, still the fuse could burst. Then the electricity is flowing over here. This is the line, and this is the neutral. Then neutral trace is directly moving towards this resistor. An optocoupler is installed here. If this optocoupler is bad, it could be the cause of this problem. I will check on the diode mode these pins over here. If the multimeter shows zero reading, then it will mean that the issue is over here. No zero value is present over here. Means that the issue could not be here. Now I will put the multimeter on continuity mode. Now I will check this 47 microfarads 450 volt capacitor. No beep is present on this capacitor. Now I will put the multimeter on diode mode. And I will test the bridge rectifier. Put the negative probe on the positive pin of the rectifier. The rest of the pins will be checked with the positive pin individually. This pin is okay. The second pin is also fine. The last pin of the rectifier is also fine. Now let's move towards this IC, which is a triac. I am checking it on the diode mode. I am changing the sides of the probes. It is also okay. Now I will put the multimeter on resistance mode. And I will check this point we tested at the start. 154 kilo ohms value is shown on the multimeter. This value means that this ZNR installed in the motherboard could be bad. Now I am removing the ZNR from the motherboard to check whether it is actually bad or not. I have removed it from the motherboard. I will check the ZNR on the resistance mode. I am checking whether it shows any resistance value on the multimeter. I have to check it from both polarities. It shows no resistance value. If the ZNR is bad, it will show a resistance value inside the motherboard, as well as out of the motherboard. It is fine right now. The question now is this, what could be the problem? I will check these points again in the resistance mode. These ZNR pads show resistance values. The resistance reading could be of anything. The motherboard has many components, so it could be the resistance of any component. Now I will remove this bridge rectifier and install a new one. Because when I am checking this rectifier, it is showing a 0.498 voltage drop. This rectifier should have shown a 0.984 voltage drop. This shape of the rectifier often shows 0.984 voltage. Now I will remove the rectifier from the motherboard. This SMD rectifier is of 2 amperes. Its number is DB207S. I am installing a DIP rectifier in place of it. I have modified the motherboard a little. The pins look something like this. I have installed a 4 amperes rectifier because 2 amperes are out of stock with me. I will install another capacitor in place of it because it looks difficult that this old one could be installed, which I have removed from the motherboard. The bridge rectifier has been soldered. I have also given the shape to the legs of the capacitor and soldered them. Now let's test this motherboard. I have already installed electrical wiring with the motherboard. Now I have turned on the electric switch. The motherboard did not burst the fuse. Now I will turn the motherboard on with the remote. It is showing E1 error because thermistors are not installed with it. And this is how I fixed a bursting motherboard of the air conditioner. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.